Good morning, everybody. How is everyone doing today? Hello, Rocío, how are you? How was your weekend? Fine, I'm glad to hear that. I'm very good. Thanks for asking. Good morning, Alicia, how are you? Okay, we're going to start in 10 minutes, okay? I will be opening. Bueno, mientras esperamos que se conecten los demás en estos 2 minuticos, como ustedes ya saben, el material se les va a empezar a mandar por el grupo. Sí, por ahora lo estaremos haciendo por el grupo de WhatsApp, porque digamos como que es el medio como más fácil, ¿cierto? Para no siempre como tener que mandar correos y eso, sino que les llegue directamente. El material se les va a seguir enviando de manera en PDF. Sí, yo se los mandé en Word. Pero la coordinadora me escribe inmediatamente que debe ser en PDF, entonces para que sepan. Sí, que de ahora en adelante el material será en PDF. ¿Qué más? We're going to try to do speaking activity every class. Sí, nosotros trabajamos, digamos, la parte gramatical, because for me it's very important. Es muy importante también que ustedes sepan cómo, cuál es el orden de la oración, ¿cierto? Cómo debe ir un verbo conjugado en este tiempo, cómo debe ir la forma negativa, cómo debe ir la forma interrogativa, right? I think it's very important. But we're going to practice as well, ¿sí? Entonces ya, probablemente ya la última actividad de cada clase sea una actividad de speaking. Entonces la idea es que participemos todos. Porque no siempre participemos los mismos, sino que si tenemos la posibilidad de hablar, de tener pues el micrófono, podamos usarlo para entonces hacer el ejercicio de speaking, right? Porque probablemente yo les estaría preguntando al azar, ¿sí? O sea, ya no es como que, ay, ¿quién quiere participar? No. Les voy a estar preguntando ya directamente. Y la única manera como que digan, no, es que no puedo, es porque en verdad no tienen micrófono, de pronto hay mucho, mucho ruido background, que ¿okay? Tiene como mucho sonido atrás de ustedes. So, I think you have to take into consideration those aspects. And that's it. So we're going to start now. Bueno. Entonces, we on Friday started studying this topic, right? Used to and didn't used to. And basically, we said that we use used to refer to past actions, right? When we talk about something we did regularly in the past, but do not do it now. So when we used to, it means that we're talking about habits or actions that we did in the past, but now in the present, we don't do them anymore. We do another activities, right? Other activities. So I will show you again some examples. We have these ones, examples. When I was a kid, I used to sleep very early, right? So as you can see, we are referring to simple past. We are using simple past because we are talking about a past action. So probably in the present, I don't go to bed early, right? Esto era en el pasado, solía irme a la cama a dormir temprano, pero entonces cuando uso used to, significa que es un hábito pasado, ¿cierto? Que ya no lo hago en el presente. En el presente probablemente ya estoy, digamos, con otro hábito. Probablemente ya me voy a dormir más tarde. ¿Sí? We have this one. When my father was 30 years old, he used to go to the gym. Cuando mi padre tenía 30 años, él solía ir al baño. So used to is like solía, right? And didn't used to, which is a negative way, no solía. When my father was 30 years old, he used to go to the gym. Remember that in this case, for the third person and the other pronoun is the same structure. We used to. Always the same. And after the two, well, we add the verb. ¿Cierto? Ya agregamos entonces la acción del pasado. Pero siempre con esta expresión, clave, used to. In past. En pasado. We have this example as well. They didn't used to go to the park when they were kids. Ellos no solían ir al parque cuando eran niños. They didn't used to go to the park when they were kissed. We didn't used to like eating carrots. No nos solía gustar comer zanahorias. We didn't used to like eating carrots. And finally, these examples. Do you used to be a teacher? We are asking, right? This is a question. Did you used to be a teacher? So did, because simple past. And as we can see, we have an auxiliar. Did is the auxiliar for simple past. So the verb, the auxiliar verb, which is used, goes in its base for, en su forma base, ¿cierto? Recordemos que cuando tenemos auxiliares, simple present or simple past, in this case, simple past, which the auxiliar is did, the verb has to be in its base for. And finally, the main verb, ¿cierto? El verbo principal, que también entonces va en la forma base porque we have a preposition to. Did he used to study French? Did he used to study French? And remember the answers, okay? If, for example, I ask you, did you used to be a teacher? And you want to say yes, you used to be a teacher because, well, you did it in the past. You can answer, I will write in, in this part. Did you used to be a teacher? Yes, I did. If you did. Or, no, I didn't. If you didn't. Positive, negative answer. In this case, because we are talking about you. So the question is for you. So I answer with I. Now let's pay attention to this one. Did he used to study French? We can say yes, he did. Or no, he didn't. And that will be the answers. Yes, he did, not he didn't. Or you can say also, if you want to, let's say, answer in a longer way, you can say, yes, I used to, example with this. Yes, I used to be a teacher. Yes, I used to be a teacher. Sí, yo solía ser un profesor. O simplemente, yes, I did. Or yes he used to be he used to study French. Yes, he used to study French. Or no he didn't used to study French. Good morning, Sophie, how are you? Okay, those are the possible answers. Okay, so we're going to practice with this. What are we going to do with this exercise? We have use information to practice making statements about past habits. And the exercise is giving us two activities, one in the past and one in the present. So for example, this one is the activity for the past and this one for the present. And we have the action, right? Play. So the sentence will be, she used to play tennis, but now she plays golf. Ella solía jugar tenis, pero ahora juega golf. She used to play tennis, but now she plays golf. So we have the first activity. used to, because we are talking about past habit, un hábito pasado. And the other part, well, it has, but now she plays golf. She plays golf, we are referring to the present, ¿cierto? La actividad que ella ya hace ahora, ya no juega tenis, sino que juega golf. Sorry, so, We are going to start with this one. We have day London, now Paris, and we have the action leave. So, what's the answer? They used to live in London, now they live in Paris. Good, Rocío. So the answer will be, they used to live in London. Puedo decir now, o what now, ¿cierto? Pero ahora, o ahora simplemente. So let's say, now they live in Paris. I am going to change the font, okay? Para hacerlo un poquito más grande. I think this can work. Okay. So very good. This is the first answer. Okay. Very good, Vivian. Just remember that in this part, we are referring to present, simple present habits. So we use the verb and that's it. Yeah. Recordemos que en el presente simple no necesitamos el auxiliar are, ese es para el presente continuo, porque simplemente tenemos el verbo, ¿cierto? Conjugado en presente. Ahora ellos viven en París. Usaríamos are si dijéramos living, ¿cierto? They are living in Paris. Ellos están viviendo en París. Ahí sí necesitaríamos el auxiliar. In this case, it's not necessary. Two, we swim in every week, now swimming once a month. What do you think is the answer? Okay, we used to go swimming every week, but now, okay, but now we go swimming once a month. Okay, so we used to go So we used to go swimming every week. Now we go swimming once a month. ¿Cierto? Vamos a nadar, go swimming.
Teacher, una pregunta.
Yes.
¿En la primera parte no va el verbo en infinitivo? ¿No sería used to swim?
Okay. En this one, el único verbo que es infinitivo es el go, ¿cierto? Porque el used to, como te decía, es para hablar de hábitos pasados. Entonces, como estamos hablando del pasado, el used to always has to be in simple past. Siempre se tiene que colocar en pasado. Lo que va en infinitivo es el verbo ya principal, que en este caso es el verbo ir, go. Entonces, en este caso, used to, que es la expresión de solíamos, como estamos hablando en pasado, goes in past, and go in, let's say, infinitive. Cuando ya hacemos la oración en presente, como estamos hablando en presente, recuerda que en el presente los verbos no se conjugan, ¿cierto? Lo único que se conjuga es cuando hablamos de tercera persona, con la S o S al final. En este caso tenemos we, nosotros, entonces el verbo va normal, con go.
Ok, thank you, teacher.
You are very welcome. So yes. Muy bien. Recordemos que sí, en este caso el go va en infinitivo, entonces no necesitamos ningún auxiliar, ¿cierto? Porque si estuviéramos hablando de we're going, ¿cierto? Estamos yendo, ya una acción continua, una acción progresiva que hace referencia al presente continuo, entonces usaríamos are, which is the auxiliar. But in this case, we are talking about simple present. Recordemos que una de los usos del simple present es hablar de hábitos, ¿cierto? De daily activities. Pues en ese caso, como es algo que yo hago diario, es un hobby, un pasatiempo que yo tengo, usamos entonces el infinitivo, ¿cierto? Porque es algo que yo hago siempre. No es algo que esté haciendo en el momento, por eso no usamos are ni es. No decimos yo estoy nadando o ellos están nadando, porque no es una acción progresiva, sino que es una acción que se refiere entonces a un hobby o a un hábito. Esa es la diferencia entre esos dos tiempos, para que recordemos. Y yo, así, de pronto ustedes también necesitan como que no, es que, profe, necesito repasar el pasado simple, necesito repasar el presente simple, por favor. Ya ustedes me dicen como que el tiempo también necesitan reforzar y ya yo entonces planeo la clase para que reforcemos el tiempo, ¿sí? No hay ningún problema, solamente es que me digan si de pronto se sienten como flojitos en algún tiempo o en algún uso de un tiempo o la diferencia entre este tiempo con este y yo ya les preparo una clase con eso, ¿sí? Para que lo tengan en cuenta. Bueno, vamos con number three. Tenemos, he never the newspaper, now the newspaper, every day. Ay, también les pido disculpas si de pronto estoy sonando muy ronca, es que me dio gripa, entonces por eso estoy como esforzando un poquito la voz. Sorry for that. Do you have the answer for this one? Remember that if you want, you can also give the answers using your microphone, ¿sí? Si quieren de pronto mejor hacerlo a manera de speaking, decir las oraciones en speaking sería mucho mejor, ¿cierto? Para que practiquemos pronunciation también y de cierta manera fluidez. Para que no siempre sea como que por el chat y las ideas que también se motiven ya a empezar a hablarlo. Aunque sea empezando por estas oraciones simples, no importa. Para que empecemos a practicar.
Hi, teacher.
Hello. What's your name? Sorry, no, ¿quién fue la que habló?
Teacher.
Ah, Vivian. Hello, Vivian. Do you want to participate using your microphone? Yes. Okay, yes, perfect. Teacher. Go ahead.
Okay. He uses to read. Never. The newspaper.
Okay.
New read to newspaper every day.
Vivian, newspaper. Excellent, Vivian. Thank you. Muy bien. Qué bueno escucharte la voz. Entonces, he used to read the newspaper. Now he read the newspaper every day. Yeah, it's good. But in this case, we have never. He never, right? Él nunca. Entonces, como tenemos aquí el nunca, we can say, podemos decir, he never used to read the newspaper, ¿cierto? Agregar primero el never, el nunca. O simplemente decir, he didn't used to read the newspaper. Él no solía leer el periódico, porque el never es una connotación negativa, ¿cierto? Nunca. Entonces, podemos decir, he never, muy bien, Natalia. He never used to read the newspaper. O he didn't used to read the newspaper, but the other part is good. Muy bien, Vivian. Congratulations. You did it good. You're very welcome. And remember that in this case, since we have third person, como tenemos tercera persona, the verb has to be with an S at the end. ¿Cierto? Ahora lee el periódico cada día. O todos los días. Excelente. This one. What's the answer?
Teacher, I used to watch TV a lot, but now I never watch TV.
Excelente. Thank you, Rocío. I used to watch TV a lot. But now I never watch TV. Muy bien. Just remember that the pronunciation for this, la pronunciación como para hacer expresiones, used to. Okay? Used to.
Okay.
I used to watch TV. Yes. You're very welcome. Okay, that's good. Muy bien, Natalia. Just the a lot, que significa mucho, ¿cierto? Robert, al final. I used to watch TV a lot. Now I never watch TV. Yeah, it's good. And the last one. What's the answer for this one?
She used to work at supermarket, but now she was work a bank.
She work or she works? What do you think?
She works a bank.
In a bank. Excellent. Good. She used to work in a supermarket, but now she works in a bank. Excellent. Good. Very good, Natalia. Muy bien, Vivian. Just in this case, en este caso, como hablamos ya de, o en un lugar en específico donde ya trabajaba, we use the preposition in, ¿cierto? En un banco, en un supermercado. And that's it. Okay, just to take in consideration something, solo para que tengan en cuenta algo, muchas veces en grammar use, ¿cierto? El uso de la gramática, digamos que es una habilidad del inglés. En el inglés está el reading, speaking, listening, and use of grammar, and writing, ¿cierto? Son cinco habilidades que se trabajan. El use of grammar, que es el uso de la gramática, normalmente ustedes les dan como este tipo de oraciones, pero muchas veces esas oraciones les falta algo. O les falta el auxiliar, o les falta el verbo conjugado, o les falta una preposición, o les falta un sujeto. Entonces, siempre que tengamos como ese tipo de ejercicios, mira qué es lo que falta para que en la respuesta lo complementemos, ¿sí? Para que lo tengamos en cuenta. De pronto en los exámenes les salen ejercicios así. Ustedes sí, obviamente, deben usar todo lo que les dan, pero aparte de eso, si necesitan agregar como, digamos, el verbo, ¿cierto? Acá, por ejemplo, le dan el verbo work, pero se los dan solito. Ustedes saben que lo tienen que conjugar aquí, en la segunda clause, ¿cierto? Tienen que colocar también la preposición in porque estamos hablando de un lugar. So, just a tip, ¿cierto? Solo como un tip para que lo tengamos en cuenta cuando presenten un examen. Bueno, so now we're going to move to the listening practice. A la actividad de listening. What are we going to do in this activity? We're going to listen to a conversation between Peter and Anna, and we're going to complete the spaces or the gaps with the information we have. Oh, just give me 1 second, I will scroll down this. Yeah, with the information we have in the chart, ¿cierto? Ustedes, teniendo ya el material acceso a él, tienen como las palabras. Entonces, yo lo que hice fue, pues, ya colocar el listening acá, como el script, y pues dejé el último el cuadrito porque ustedes van a tener acceso a él. Pero entonces, quiero saber cómo podemos mejor hacer este listening. Do you prefieren que escuchemos, bueno, esta conversación está como dividida por partes. La había hecho así, pues, porque para que fuera más fácil la vista desde acá, pero de ahora en adelante voy a dejar ya toda la conversación y las respuestas abajo. Pero en este caso, pues, tenemos la conversación de want, entonces podemos. Vamos a hacer. Podemos escuchar this part de corrido, ¿sí? Dos veces, escucharemos cada parte dos veces. Or, if you want, we can listen to the conversation and we complete line by line. O escuchamos la conversación one time, una vez, y lo completamos ya, digamos, línea por línea. Entonces, ah, how are you? You for ages. Y acá, stop, y completamos esta parte. O prefiere mejor de corrido, ustedes van completando ahí. y después socializamos. I think the second one is better. Yo diría que la segunda es la mejor. I don't know. But what you want. En este caso voy a dejar que ustedes decidan cómo quieren mejor hacerlo. Las dos de corrido y ustedes van completando ahí.
Teacher, la segunda.
Y después socializamos o mejor.
Profe, la segunda es la mejor.
Dime.
De una en una, profe.
Second one, línea por línea, ¿qué dicen las demás?
No, profe, mejor de corrido.
Ah, ¿de corrido?
Sí.
Okay. Do you agree? ¿Ustedes están de acuerdo con que sea así? Pues son mujeres, right? Ay, sí, solo tenemos mujeres en este grupo. Bueno, Vivian dice que de una en una. Natalia, yes, what? Ok, Rocío dice de una en una, entonces de una en una va ganando. What about the other ones? How do you want to do the exercise? ¿Cómo quieren hacer las demás el ejercicio? Ahí.
La mayoría ganan, profe.
Neutral. Bueno, entonces hagámoslo. Entonces, la en bailar, ¿cierto? Entonces, en ese caso, I am just, we're going to try to listen at first, ¿sí? The first time we try to listen to comprehend what the speaker is saying and we complete. Entonces vamos a tratar como de comprender la primera, ¿listo? Ya que lo vamos a hacer line by line. So, let's go. Ah, bueno, antes de, me confirman si pueden escuchar el listening, ¿sí? Yo les pongo el audio, solamente va a ser como prueba.
Hi. It's Anna, isn't it?
Can you listen?
Sí, señora. Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So we're going to start.
Hi, it's Anna, isn't it?
Hey, Peter, how are you? I haven't seen you for ages.
Okay, so this one? What's the answer? Excelente. I haven't seen you for ages. Good. For ages. Haven't seen you, right? I haven't seen you, yes. Excellent. Let's continue.
Yeah, I think it was 4 years ago at Kathy's graduation party. Do you still see her?
I saw her last week, in fact. She's just had a baby.
Oh.
Okay, did you listen this one? Muy bien, Vivian. She just had a baby, right? He used a contraction for simple present. She's just had. She just had a baby. Ella acabado de tener un bebé. Good. Remember that she's in this case is the contraction for she has, right? Simple, present perfect, sorry. Good. Let's continue.
Just had a baby.
Oh, wow. I can't believe that. Kathy, a mother.
I can't believe how different you look.
Do you think so?
Yeah. You've changed your hairstyle completely.
Do you listen? You've changed, good. You've changed your hairstyle completely. Very good, Vivian.
You used to have really long hair, didn't you?
Listen again this part, que de pronto pasó un poquito rápido.
Believe how different you look.
Do you think so?
Yeah. You've changed your hairstyle completely. You used to have really long hair, didn't you?
Okay. Do you listen the other part? Yes, what's the answer? One more time, of course. Let's listen again.
Do you think so?
Yeah. You've changed your hairstyle completely. You used to have really long hair, didn't you?
Yeah.
So let's say the chart. ¿Sí? The chart creo que tenemos esa, yeah. What's the answer? You used to have. Yes. You used to have really long hair, didn't you? Solías tener cabello largo, ¿verdad? Excelente. Muy bien. Let's continue.
Lee, you used to have really long hair, didn't you?
Yeah. I got tired of washing and brushing it 5 times a day.
And of course, you used to have a beard. You've shaved that off too.
Okay, this one. You used to have a beard. Muy bien, Rocío. Tú solías tener barba. You used to have beard. You've shaved that off too. Shave is like rasurar, ¿sí? Como tú te lo has rasurado también. Yes.
You've shaved that off too.
Hey, that's true. I haven't had a beard for at least 3 years now.
Do you listen? I'm going to repeat.
You used to have a beard. You've shaved that off too.
Hey, that's true. I haven't had a beard for at least 3 years now.
Remember, we have the answer, right? Recuerden que acá tenemos las opciones. I haven't had just that he speaks like so fast in this part, ¿cierto? Ahora ya más rápido en esta parte. But yes, the answer is haven't had. I haven't had a beard for at least 3 years now. Good. And I think this is the last part. Yes.
And where are your glasses? You've stopped wearing your glasses with the red frames.
Oh. Hey, that's true. I haven't had a beard for at least 3 years now.
And where are your glasses? You've stopped wearing your glasses with the red frames.
Oh, they were terrible. I can't believe you can still remember them. I wear contact lenses now.
You've stopped. Good. The last one, right? You stopped wearing your glasses with the red frames. Good. Okay. So let's continue with the second part. Vamos entonces a continuar con la segunda parte. This is the conversation and this. Este cuadrito de acá son las posibles respuestas.
They were so you, those glasses. So, what else is different with you?
Well, I've changed my job too. You remember, I used to work in the bookstore.
Okay, we have two gaps in this one to complete. So, listen again.
Oh, you, those glasses. So, what else is different with you?
Well, I've changed my job too. You remember, I used to work in the bookstore.
The first one, well. I changed my job too. Muy bien. I changed my job too. And the second gap, muy bien. I used to work in the bookstore. You remember I used to work in the bookstore? Excellent. And we have, yeah. So let's listen what's next.
What else is different with you?
Well, I've changed my job too. You remember I used to work in the bookstore?
Yeah.
Well, I have another job now and it's a lot better.
What do you do now?
Store.
Yeah.
Well, I have another job now and it's a lot better.
What do you do now?
So, well. I have another job now and it's a lot better. Good. Muy bien, Rocío. And we're going to listen to the last part.
Job now is a lot better.
What do you do now?
I work for a computer software company in the city. The pay is great and the job is pretty interesting too.
That sounds terrific. What about Benji?
Benji? Who's he?
Don't tell me you've forgotten about that old Volkswagen you used to drive around in. What about Benji?
Benji? Who's he?
Don't tell me you've forgotten about that old Volkswagen you used to drive around in.
Excellent, Vivian. Don't tell me you've forgotten, right? You've forgotten about the old Volkswagen you used to drive. Good. You used to drive around in. Okay, this was forgotten. Excellent. And now the last part. Vamos con la última parte. So remember, these are the answers.
Benji, wow, I can't believe you remembered. I bought a new car now, and it doesn't have a name. So what about you? I can't believe you remembered. I bought a new car now, and it doesn't have a name.
I bought a new car now. Break it. That's the answer. I fought. Right? I fought. Yeah. Yo he comprado un carro nuevo. And it doesn't have a name.
Benji, wow, I can't believe you remembered. I bought a new car now, and it doesn't have a name. So what about you? What's changed in your life since we last saw each other?
Very little, actually. I've moved into a new apartment on the other side of town. That place I used to live in was just too small and cramped for me.
Okay. So, very little actually, I've moved. Good, I've moved. Into a new apartment. I moved into a new apartment on the other side of town. And the other one, I... I used to live in good. So this is the answer. Good.
But you live so close to your job.
Yeah, well, I've changed my job too, just like you.
But you live so close to your job.
Yeah, well, I've changed my job too, just like you. Now, I work for my father in the sales department, so I'm pretty close to the office.
I've changed my job too. And we have the last part.
Look, I've got to hurry off now, but it's been great talking to you. What do you say? Should we meet up for dinner or a drink this week and catch up on old times?
Absolutely. Here's my home number. You can reach me anytime after 7.
Okay, I'll call in a day or two and we'll get something together. Bye for now, Anna.
Bye, Peter.
And that's it. So the last one, Maris, it's been great talking. Good. It's been great talking to you. Excellent. That's it. Very good. Okay, so now we're going to move to the next activity. Yeah, we still have time. Okay, now we're going to work on the story in a better way. Vamos a trabajar entonces ya un poquito más en la estructura. Hacer un repaso en la estructura del uso in the three ways. This chart, writing the sentence in the way that is missing. La columna del medio y la negativa, and the last column, well, the interrogative. ¿Cierto? Las preguntas o la interrogativa. Entonces, como pueden ver en la primera columna, primer ejercicio, is already done. I used to go to work by car. But we have to complete the negative wave and the interrogative wave. So, that is what you have to do in this exercise. So, I used to go to work by car. What will be the negative statement for this one? Thank you.
Hi, teacher.
Hello.
I didn't use to go
yes?
To work by car.
To go to work. Yes, excellent. Muy bien. I didn't use to go to work by car. Good. And interrogative. Do you have the answer?
Did I use to go to work by car?
Muy bien, Vivian. Excellent. Did I use to go to work by car? Voy a ganar un poquito esto. Estás en esta fuente. Very good. The second one. We have the negative. You didn't used to have many friends at school. You didn't used to have many friends at school. So we have to complete the positive or affirmative wave and interrogative wave. What will be the affirmative wave?
You used to have many friends at school.
Excellent. Good. An interrogative.
Did you used to have many friends at school?
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Number three, we have the interrogative, but we're moving the affirmative and negative. And we have the, did he used to visit his grandparents at the weekend?
He used to visit his grandparents at the weekends.
Good. And the
he didn't use.
It's okay. Mm-hmm.
To visit your grandparents at the weekends.
Excellent. He didn't use to visit his grandparents at the weekend. Good. We're going to do number four. We have, she used to be my best friend. She used to be my best friend. Participate otros, please. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, the idea is that we all participate, right?
She didn't used to be my best friend.
She didn't used to be my best friend. Good.
Didn't she used to be?
Didn't or did?
I'm sorry. Did.
Yeah. Did.
Did she used to be my best friend?
Excelente. Good. Okay, let's continue with this one. We have, it didn't used to be a cinema earlier. It didn't used to be a cinema earlier. What do you think? Affirmative and interrogative way.
It used to be a cinema early.
Excellent. It used to be a cinema early. Good, Natalia. First time I hear your voice. Good. And the interrogative?
Did it used to be a cinema early?
Mm-hmm. Excellent. And the last one. We have the interrogative. Did we used to have dinner at six every evening?
We used to have dinner at six every evening.
Good. We used to have dinner at six every evening. Good. And the negative.
Didn't we used to have dinner at six every evening?
Excellent. Did we used to have dinner at six every evening? Good. Okay. Yeah, we're going to pause this. ¿Sí? Ya terminamos acá. Creo que entonces la estructura is clear, right? You know the structure for affirmative, negative, and interrogative. Excellent. So now we're going to, with the rest of time, ya con lo que nos queda tiempo, we're going to practice. Going to do. You're all going to, let's say, yeah, we have the past and present. ¿Cierto? Vamos a hablar entonces de esta mujer en past and present. And we have the habits or the actions in past and the actions she does now. ¿Cierto? Los hábitos que ya hace ahora en el presente. So, the idea is that you guys, sí, cualquiera, pueden escoger un hábito del pasado o un hábito del presente, ¿ya? If you want, for example, I want to ask about the past, ¿cierto? Quieren preguntar por el pasado. Entonces, teniendo en cuenta esta información, armamos la pregunta. Example, the first one, live in a flat. So, did she used to live in a flat in the past, for example? And the other person says, yes, she did, no, she didn't. ¿Cierto? Dependiendo, en este caso, se puede pasado. Se puede pasar. Yes, she did. ¿Cierto? Sí. Pero también puedo decir, does she live in a flat now? ¿Vive ella en un...? ¿Se escucha mal? Bueno, un momento.
Okay, guys, yeah, es porque coloqué un listening y normalmente cuando pongo un listening de una página web, después el audio se daña, okay? And if I use the cell phone, si uso el celular, van a escuchar el eco, porque aunque le quite todo el volumen del computador, se va a seguir escuchando, no sé, es un problema de Google Mix que tiene. So, we're going to stop here, vamos entonces ya a terminar acá, pero antes entonces les voy a explicar la tarea. Un momento, proyecto bien la tarea, lo que se van a hacer para mañana. So, what are you going to do for tomorrow? You have this question. Now, what are the things you usually used to do? This is a personal question for you. So, the idea is that you think about it, piensa en sobre la pregunta, and you write a minimum 7 ideas. ¿Sí? Mínimo 7 ideas. Máximo, pues, we can say 12. ¿Sí? Máximo 12. 7 minimum, maximum 12. So for example, what are the things you usually used to do? Example, me. I used to go to bed at 9 p.m. ¿Cierto? Yo solía ir a la cama a las 9 de la noche. So that's the idea. And I write it. Y la escribo. ¿Sí? Las cosas que ustedes solían hacer en el pasado. And then tomorrow we start with the class with, let's say, the ideas. ¿Sí? Vamos a empezar entonces ya mañana la clase con, leyendo como las ideas, lo que hicieron. To practice, yeah, to verify the homework, para pues verificar que la tarea queda bien, and also well, to practice pronunciation, okay? It's clear? Quedó claro entonces lo que deben hacer en cuanto a la tarea. Yes, okay. Perfect, so guys, see you tomorrow. Girls, de hecho, ya no tenemos ningún muchacho acá en la clase, solo niñas. So, yeah, see you tomorrow. I hope you have an excellent day.
See you tomorrow, teacher.
Thank you, teacher. Bye.
Thank you, teacher. Bye-bye.